Dear students, today we are going to look at a new practical, and that is from group C, and this is the practical number 1 in which we want to find out whether the given number is prime or not. So let us try to construct an algorithm and a program in 8051 assembly language to find out whether the number is a prime number or it is a combination number. If you go through our manual, so our problem statement is you can find out our problem statement is to find out whether the given number is prime or not. So either we have to find out the given number is either it's a prime number or it is a composite number. Now the objective that we are going to look at is we have to develop an algorithm to find out the prime number, and then we have to display as a flag maybe on the some port line or something like that. Then we have to get the data from the user, then we have to find out whether it is a prime or not, and we have to record and verify the result. So these are our objectives. Now the equipments those are required are either it is a desktop computer, then you require a KIL compiler. In our case, we are going to use a KIL IDE compiler for 8051. I hope you have already seen the tutorial on KIL IDE compiler. There is some addition to that that I will explain during this practical. Now before building an algorithm, we have to see few things, like the user can input his number from port number 2, and the result will be shown on port number 1 line number 0. So we are going to use port number 1 line number 0 as a flag. So whenever port number 1 line number 0 is 1, it means that the given number is prime, and whenever it is at a reset state, it means that the given number is just a combinational number or the combined number, so that the flag is reset. So this is how our mechanism is going to work. One more thing to see over here is that in a prime numbers, we don't have the numbers 0s and 1. So whatever the user is giving a number, that should be greater than 1. So that is an exception case that we are going to look at. After that, we can build up the algorithm. So these are the 9 steps through which we are going to develop an algorithm. So first of all, we are going to read a port number 2. So here the user will input its value. Then we are going to clear the port number 1. So if there is already a result, then we have to clear that result. So we are clearing port number 1. After that, we are storing the given particular number into register R2. After that, if the number is less than 3, so that is what I am saying, 0, 1 and 2. If it is less than 3, directly we are saying that the given number is a prime number, or we are not going to execute that case. So it will directly jump to the step number 9. After that, we are going to divide the given number by 2, and we are going to store its magnitude into register R0. Why we are doing this? Because let us say we have a number like a 12. So we want to find out whether it is a prime number or not, as we know that it's not a prime number, right? So what is the procedure to find it out? So first of all, what I have to do is the prime number should be divided by 1, or either it is divided by itself. So what I have to do is I have to make an algorithm which will divide this number 12 by each and every number that is from 1 to 12. So first of all, I will divide it by 1, then I will divide it by 2, then I will divide it by 3, then I will divide it by 4, so and so forth, and up to 12. Now in this case, for 1 number and for 12 number, I should get 1, then only it will be a prime number. But here in this case, you can see that this number is divided by 1, this number is divided by 2, even this number is divided by 4, and even this number is divided by 6, so it's not a prime number. Let us take another case, a very simple case, in which the number is 7. Now here, what we have to do is, if the number is 7, then it is only divided by 1, and then it is only divided by 7. But in that case, if I make a loop, then I have to divide it by 1, then I have to divide it by 2, then I have to divide it by 3, and so forth, I have to go up to a 7 number. But what happens if the number is very large? In that case, we have to iterate the loop so many times, because let us say my number is 213, so 213 is also a prime number, so I have to execute that loop 230 times. Now somehow we can make this loop, we can reduce these loops by dividing by 2. Okay, so that logic is given over here. So we don't have to go for full numbers, we can divide it by 2, and those number of iterations can be used. So you can take a paper and pencil, you can go through this, and you can find out that this is equal effective technique to find out the primary number. So after that, we are going to divide that number successively by R0, and we have to look at the remainder. Now, if the remainder is greater than 1, then we have to go to the next step, number 6. That is means we have to divide it again and again. So we have to follow this procedure, and during this procedure, we have to decrease the value of R by 1. So what are we doing? Let us say my prime number is 13, then I am dividing by 13, then I am dividing by 12, then I am dividing by 11, and so forth, until and unless I will get 1 as my remainder or 0 as my remainder. So if you are getting 1 as a remainder or 0 as a remainder, let us take two situations are there. 1 as a remainder means that it's a prime number. 0 as a remainder means that it's a non-prime number. So if R0 is equal to 1, then what we have to do is we have to set this value P1.0 is equal to 1, and then we have to set the value of P1.0 is equal to 1, else P1.0 is equal to 0. So this was the statement number 9 was for the step number 4. Now let us look at the algorithm, the flowchart. So the flowchart is like this. So first of all, we have to start, and then we have to read the port, read the number from port 2. And if the number is equal to 2, or if the number is equal to 3, then we have to go to the connector, which name is B. So what is B? So B is nothing but set P1.0 is equal to 1. Means 2 and 3 are already prime numbers, and we don't need to divide all these numbers. We can divide the number beyond this. So that we have already mentioned in step number 2 in the algorithm. Then what we have to do is, to minimize the number of loops, we have to divide that number by 2, and we have to store the value within an R0. Now during this process, if the number is greater than 1, if the number is greater than 1, then it is directly a prime number, and it will go to the step number B, and it will show that it's a prime number. Now if the number is greater than 1, then if the value is yes, then we have to divide this number by R0, and we have to check out this number, and we have to successively divide this number during this loop until and unless R0 is greater than 1. So once this R is greater than 1, if it is yes, it will go ahead. If it is no, then the number is not prime number, and we have to stop this loop. Now as you know that this is a continuous and forever loop, and that is why I have shown a stop over here, while I have shown an off-page connector over here, that is C, and that is connected to the start. So once again, it will take a number from the user, and it will try to find out whether the number is prime or not. Now according to this, we wrote down a program over here. So as you can see that there, we are just clearing the number, clearing the port number 1. After that, we are sending, we are reading a port number 2, and we are sending it to the register R2. And after that, we are saying that if the number is 2, then that directly it is a prime number. If the number is 3, then that is also a prime number. And if the number is not 2, then if the number is not 3, then it will go to the next step. And here within the loop 2, what we have did is we have reduced the number of loops, so we are making it half. After that, now here is the main logic to find out whether the number is a prime number or not. So here you can see that decrement R0, compare and jump if not equal to 1 to loop 1. So here what we are doing is we are taking a number which is stored in R2. Okay, so this is user defined number. We are taking in an accumulator, and the minimum number that is over here. Okay, so this is a divided by 2 number. So to reduce down the loops. After that, we are just dividing it, and the remainder is, of course, after a division, remainder is always stored in a register B, so that we are transferring it to a register R3, and we are just comparing whether that is 0 or not. If it is not 0, then we are just dividing again and again. Now if it is a 0, then we have to jump to where? We have to jump to here 2. Here 2 means what? It's not a prime number, because it is a divisible number. And if it is not a divisible number, then it will go to the next step, and that is set B for P1.0 and SJMP to the main. Main means we are just, once again, we are clearing the result. We are taking the number from the port number 2, and once again this loop will go on and on. So this is what is the logic that we have developed, and according to that we have to put down some observations. So here you can put some of the primary numbers, and according to that primary numbers or any numbers, what is the status of P1.0, that you can write down over here. After that you can write down your results, conclusion and few of the applications, and I have given you some of the supplementary articles over here. What is the importance of prime number, where it can be used, and so on and so forth, that I have given over here. Just go through this supplementary material. Now let us look at the kill compiler and let us try to simulate this program. Now let us start and find out the result from the kill compiler. So you can copy the code from the manual and you can paste it within a new file within a kill compiler. What you have to do is we have to make a little change, and that is while saving this file we have to go to file, save as, and we have to save this file with, let us say, our prime, this is our name, and with the extension of .a51. So A stands for assembly language and 51 stands for its program for 8051. So I have already saved it, so that is the only change that we have to make. In previous cases we have to save this file with the .c extension because those were embedded C files. Now this is an assembly language file, so we have to save this file with the .a51 extension. So that is the only change that we have to do. So once you have saved this file, you can add that file to the source group 1, and here I have already added this file. So here is the logic. So as I told you, number 2 and number 3 are already prime number, and then we'll clear cut say that these are the two are the prime numbers. And let us see how this logic works. I'll compile this program. Okay, so 0 error 0 warning. So I'll go to debug, start stop debug session. Okay, and here I have already taken two ports. So our port number 2 is going to be an input port, and port number 1 is going to be an output port. In port 1, the line number 0 will be our output port. So whenever the flag is 1, it means that the given number is a prime number, and if the flag is 0, it means that the number is a combinational number or the non-prime number. Now as it has many iterations, I'll not run this program in a stepwise mode, I'll run in a continuous mode. So before running that program, I should give some input at port number 2. So I am going to give the input as number 3, which is a prime number, and let us run this program. As you can see that our flag is flashing, and it's flashing means the given number is a prime number. Now simply if I tick mark on this, I'm giving number 7. This number 7 is also a prime number. Now let us modify this by just clicking on this, which is nothing but a 6. Now 6 is not a prime number, so this flag is at a reset state. So this is how we can find out whether the given number is prime or not. Now we can have let us say number 11, so which is nothing but a combination of 1, 0, 0 and 1, 1. Okay, so this is also a prime number. Now if the number is bigger, it will take more time to show on this port number 1. Okay, so that we have to remember, because it has to go through too many iterations, and within those too many iterations we have made half the iteration, still those are more iterations, so that is why it is taking a longer time to show the result. Whereas for number 3, it is just within a second it shows you the result, whereas for the number 11 it takes a more time to show the particular result. Okay, so this is how we should work, and we should find out whether the number is prime or not. So I'll come out of debug mode, and I am going to paste this program within the description video below. You can download the same program and you can copy and paste within your kill compiler, but you have to remember while saving this file, we have to save this file with a .a51 extension, and then we can able to simulate this program file.